Now we're on part two, where I finish up this gradient. So what I'm doing now is a little bit of dry brush stuff. With dry brush, you basically just pull all the water out and have your pavement on sort of a mixing tray of sorts. You can go more bold than this, I just didn't. There we go. Even that's a little bit wet for dry brush. Yeah, that's more like what you get with dry brush. This is something you can do on non-watercolor paper too. If you learn how to dry brush good enough, you can do this on like coloring books and stuff and like normal paper. I know I've done it often enough on like a school paper. I'm not like I'd want to like draw on or something. That's a little bit of dry brush. Let's pull a darker brown into it. Did my mom's dress is what makes throughout all of this a good you can there's two ways you can do this. You can either have a paper towel on hand, which is what a lot of people do, or you can directly pull the water from the brush, which is what I do a lot. The other way is probably easier on the brush, but I have natural bristles. Synthetic also should do well, but You're gonna want some kind of watercolor brush, to be perfectly honest with you. They sell good synthetics, but as long as it's branded for watercolor, chances are it's okay. As you get higher up the food chain, you might get something like silver black velvet, but that's like a few years off from like the start of watercolor when you should start thinking about stuff like that. For now, there's some recommendations I can give you. My biggest one, the one I learned on when I started out, was Cotman by Winsor & Newton. It's a very good student brand, and it'll do a lot for you. That combined with some Canson XL and some like some basic Princeton like Grumbacher brushes that you can find at like a Michaels, one brush will do you. Make it like a decent size round, and you can do a lot with it. Like, I've done washes, as you can see here, and I've done some fine work, some fine brushwork stuff. Let's get back to our watercolor. let's see what the gradient looks like. Let's see. Oh, my camera's dying. Or my phone's dying, sorry. Sorry about that. Damn it, I plugged in the wrong one. Of course that would happen. It's an okay gradient. I've done better. I kind of don't like that one. Let me really quickly... See, that ought to work. Yeah. I really like that song. I don't know why that ended up on this playlist. There, that's a better gradient than I did over there, I'd say. I've done better. I'll have to work up on... It's been a while, actually, since I've done something basic like this, I'll be honest. Okay. Let's try something a little bit different. Let's try blending colors. Move that over here.
too.
So usually starting out with that and then filling a little bit of this. Yeah, that really didn't come out as well as I'd like it to. Let's try it again. I've done better demonstrations than that, I think. Let's try a way that's more familiar to me, I'd say. That's annoying. Damn, bro. You gonna do me like, alright, I guess we're gonna have to do that again. I accidentally had some of my my black from earlier on the lip of the page. Let's see what the time's at. Let's do let's do that. So the way I'm doing this this time is a bit different than usual. I'm gonna let this color dry for a bit, but in the meantime,
Yeah,
Why are you so sure? So you can do what I did earlier and gradate from one to the other, on top of each other, sort of. I mean, you can do some active stuff, but like the way I was doing it wasn't working at the time. Usually that stuff works better than... And then usually you can blend the edges a little bit. Damn. A bit better of a gradation, but you... It's hard. Usually I can do better. I need to refine my technique more and get back to some of my basics. It's been so long since I've done something like this that my skills are a little bit rusty. But let's see, that's a good way of doing it. Let's revisit our thing over here. And we're gonna do some more wet on dry. So wet on dry is also called glazing, or can be glazing depending on when you use it. So if I'm using it like here, per se, it's glazing. If I was to use it just on like flat paper with nothing on it, then you can sort of make the argument that it's wet on dry. Yeah, they're both just terms. The techniques would matters. Gonna apply a little bit of our gradation skills we've been practicing for a little bit. And as you can see, when you do wet over wet, or wet over dry, and you've already dry brushed, you can sort of lose a little bit of your details. Don't mind this. I've done better. And I will continue to do better. Interesting. Let's do some cool stuff. When you have some very concentrated paper and you just drop color on, this is the sort of stuff you get. A lot of artists like this sort of visual effect. I don't really use this type of thing that often, to be honest with you. A lot of the time, I guess another thing I could touch on really briefly. That's sort of the foundation of why wet on wet works. Is that watercolor will often follow the path of least resistance with water. So let's do this. Let's do some fine line stuff. Let's use a little bit of purple. So you probably can't even see it, can you? But the path I made of water is gonna naturally follow the paper. Interesting, huh? And then obviously you pull the excess out. You can do a lot with this sort of stuff. I'm probably not going to do much more than this, these two parts to practice and show you these sort of things, but they're worth noting about when you paint. Thanks for joining me. It's been fun.